William Kurk here again with another episode of Synth Sounds Of, and today we bring you the Synth Sounds Of the Minimoog. Now today we have a Minimoog in our possession, but if you don't have one, you can use software or even the Behringer Model D. Let's get into some Moog stuff, shall we? So on the Mount Rushmore of funk bass lines, obviously, there's only a few that really stand out. And one of them is Flashlight. Parliament. I mean, enough said, right? Bernie Worrell, definitely one of the grandfathers, if not the pioneer of the synth funk movement, gave us one of the funkiest bass lines in history. And it wouldn't be right without a Flashlight. This is just a general blanket setting we have. It's not really dialed into anything particular. So that's how it sounds right now. And so to get this sound, this bass sound, we're gonna start on the left side of the Moog. We're gonna turn our glide down about 4. We're gonna hit the oscillator modulation. Bam, it's on. We're gonna turn the range down to 32. It's at 16 already, so blot out. Good to go. Take this middle knob here, dial it right in the middle. We got some sawtooth action happening, so we got our sawtooth setting, oscillator 1 and 2 are set to sawtooth. So for the filter modulation, I'm gonna turn this off, turn number 1 on, and keep number 2 off. OWF, off. Our cutoff frequency is around 2. And now we're gonna take the filter emphasis, take that down to 0. Getting a little funky now. Uh-oh, watch out, y'all. In the amount of contour, let's take that at noon o'clock on your dial. See how that sounds? Okie dokes. Our attack is down. We're gonna take the decay around 600. And our sustain level all the way up. We're gonna take this, take it all the way to the left. Triangle love. So this is where our setting is at the moment. And I noticed that it's a little bit aggressive. And if you're gonna perform it live, this actually will work really good because you cut through. You want that bass to cut through, but if you're trying to get more of the authentic vibe of the sound, let's take this cutoff frequency down around -2 instead of 2. We can take it down even a little bit more. Take it down to like 3, -3. Personally, I like the bite. If you're going for something more organic and authentic, you may want to take the bite down a little bit, you know, put some braces on that thing. We got it pretty close and got it in the vibe of the song. So that's Flashlight. In a nutshell. So the next song, or should I say the next question I have for you is, are friends electric? Gary Numan thinks that friends are electric, or perhaps he's wondering if they're electric, but today we're gonna start on the left side, on the controller side. What I did is take the glide all the way down. We need that glide to be all the way down. Now we're gonna veer our way into the oscillator bank. We're gonna turn that off. So oscillator 1, 2, 3, we set it at 16. We're gonna take oscillator 2, nudge that in the middle, and oscillator 3, nudge this in the middle. Saw action, right on oscillator 3, oscillator 2, the same thing, and oscillator 1, the same thing. And then we're gonna turn this off, then we're gonna turn Number two, on the keyboard control off. And we're gonna dial this filter emphasis. That should do it. Let's take this at noon. And then we're gonna go down to attack time. Attack time should be all the way down. Decay time, 600. Sustain level, let's take this all the way up to 10. Attack time at 0. And then we're gonna take the decay time, put this over around 600. Sustain level should be all the way up. So let's hear where we're at right now. As you can hear, sounds like a freight train coming straight into Lakeshore Drive, you know? I don't know why this is sounding like this. And then I wondered, okay, right now I'm gonna hit oscillator control toggle right here. Just like that. Magic in a pan. So this is what it sounds like in the context of how we got it set right now. So let's kick that funky beat. Instrument has spanned all types of genres and styles of music. It has given way to one of the most popular hooks in music history. Ain't nothing but a G-thang, baby. Too low, down G's going crazy. Death Row is the label that pays me. Unfadable, so please don't try to fade me. So it's no secret that Dr. Dre was heavily, heavily influenced by Parliament in the funk movement. And so we're gonna use the Moog to capture that spirit. So this is what it sounds like right now. More standard sound Moog, you know what I'm saying? So we're gonna modify that. Now our glide, we're gonna need some glide for that. So we're gonna take this lucky number 7. And then what we're gonna do, we're gonna turn the glide on. We're gonna set the oscillator modulation off. The range for our oscillator 1 is set to 2. Oscillator number 2 is set to 2. And then we're gonna take this middle dial, set it at noon o'clock. We're gonna use saws for our oscillators. Bam, bam, bam. Thank you, ma'am. We may need to modify this a little bit, but this is kind of where we're gonna set it for now. Uh-oh, that sounds like an Impala coming down the block. So now we're gonna move over to our filter zone. We're gonna turn keyboard control 1 on. Take this 1, we're gonna go to the filter emphasis, 4, maybe even 3. Take that all the way down. Joink off. The attack time all the way down. The decay to around 200. And the sustain level all the way up, 10. Loudness contour, we're gonna keep that at 0. And then decay time, 400 atmosphere. Sustain level all the way up to 10. So now that we've got our settings in cue, one of the things that I need to mention is on oscillator number 2. So check this out. Ooh-wee, this is a test. And now we move it just to the center. So the oscillator has to be set dead on. I mean, you have to play it and adjust it or else you're gonna get this. And that's not a G thing, that's a Volkswagen thing. That's a soccer mom thing. This is a G thing right here. We'll be right back. on to a very unique period of time where, I don't know, I was young. That's all I'm gonna say. And there was this band that was like super huge, right? Devo. There's that one song you all know? We're not gonna do that song. We're gonna do Smart Patrol. So Devo was known for their use of synthesizers all throughout their music, and this song is no exception. But Mark Mothersbaugh definitely did something unique with this song. And we're gonna focus on the ARP sound that starts the song off and it appears throughout the song. And this is a sound that it's hard to describe, and we get it as close as we could get it because, you know, it's kind of hard to rekindle the essence of that sound. We're gonna adjust the glide to 8, right about there, oscillator bank. So we're gonna adjust this to, oops, went too far, 16, and then we're gonna adjust the oscillator 2 to 16 as well. Take the middle dial all the way up to 7, all the way up. Adjust these waveforms accordingly. Bam, bam. And now oscillator 3 is really used as a modulation source. We're gonna take this all the way low. We're gonna have to toggle this switch, and then we're gonna turn this on. Take keyboard control number 1 off and keyboard control 2 off. And now we're going to adjust the cutoff frequency. 2 here is good. We will adjust accordingly. We're gonna take this down to 0. And now we're going to take the amount of contour right in the middle. We're gonna take the attack time down to negative, decay time to 600, sustain level all the way up to 10, 0 here for the attack time, 600 for the decay, and sustain level at 10. And let's see what it sounds like. Now that's a pretty freaky sound, if I must say so. For the oscillation, so check this out. We had it kind of around 6. We needed to be tagged all the way up to 7 just to get the full effect. And there's a bit of coordination required to get the sound effect, because check this out. I'm just gonna demonstrate. So where it's at now, we're gonna take pitch down, get it low, and then as we go up, dial it up. Now, as you notice, this is totally a Devo thing to do. Like, geek level 5000, okay? Rather difficult to do accurately in a performance setting. So, legend has it that maybe during the recording of this song, maybe Mark's Moog was modified to be able to ascend and then go back down that way, or maybe it was done in sound design for some post-production. But nevertheless, just to humor everybody, I'm gonna try to actually do it. Think of it like, you know, trying to build an airplane from scratch and hope that it doesn't crash. So in order to get to the full range of the peak of the actual sound, I had to take the first oscillator up to 8, from 16 to 8, in order to get to the very top. And it's kind of a circus act because I have to start with the pitch all the way down now, take the pitch up, hold the note, turn the glide off, and turn the pitch wheel back to 0 just to get the effect. So, welcome to Nuthin. Forgot to turn the glide on. One more time, check this out. course, that time has come in our Synth Sounds legacy where we have fallen upon the most inevitable of bands and influences of the synth era. And of course, I'm talking none other than Pink Floyd. Shine on, you crazy diamond. So this song definitely goes for a while. And just to show you how deep this song is, we're gonna be covering a synth part from part three. And it's a synth brass sound. Rick Wright was a genius and a mad scientist of sorts, and he used various keyboards throughout the recordings, but obviously we're gonna be using the Moog, and we're going to address this very signature solo for Pink Floyd. The glide. Oh, psych, we're gonna take it back up to six. Gotcha, ha ha. Glide is on, decay is on. Now, we're going to adjust the modulation 20% of the modulatory range. Then we're gonna turn the oscillator modulation off. We're gonna turn the range 8. That should definitely do it. For the first one, the waveform, saw it out. Then we'll go to oscillator 2. We're gonna put it on 8. Oscillator down the middle, put that at noon o'clock. Copy that, bam. Oscillator 3, keep that all the way low. It's just gonna be low. Take this wave, boom. Filter modulation, toggle that on. Disengage number 1, but engage number 2. Cutoff frequency, 0. Filter emphasis, 0. Amount of contour, 6, give it 600 right there for now. 600, let's take the sustain level all the way up. Loudness contour, the attack time, somewhere in the mid zone of 4 and 2, 3. 3 is good for me. Let's take the sustain level, 7. Ooh. That's a nice sound we get. It's soft, it's brassy, and it definitely gives us the feeling that a diamond is shining crazily. It's a little aggressive. That actually will work if you're doing a live performance. You want your sounds to cut a little deeper when you're performing live. But to get that nuance on the recording, maybe you can also bring it up a little bit. You can always go to Reverb, get you one of these firsthand, or you can get the Behringer, you can get the software, you can get anything that has a Moog name on it and just synth out all day and all night. Moog lives, rock lives, hip hop lives, soul lives, R&B lives, funk lives, pop lives, and even Moog polka, which you might be into.